1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
All right, what did I get up to?
Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of How Many, the only podcast that actually counts. I'm here with Junior Lopez, Gary Grant, and myself. We're waiting for Jesse Jackson and Scott Matula to come back from their big protest in Washington, D.C. We hope that they said their piece and we'll be back soon. Just kidding, folks. They're not anywhere near the White House, but at least not the one there. Maybe they are in the one by Valley Ranch. We're here with Junior. We've got an exciting topic about movie weapons.
Yes. About a year or so ago, there was another podcast called the Gutting the Sacred Cow podcast. So shout out to them. But they posted a topic on Twitter asking what the coolest movie weapon was. And they got a lot of response. When I thought about that topic, I thought, man, this would make a really good How Many episode. So what I have done is did some of the research online like we did. And I have come up with 40 very interesting, very cool movie weapons, and we can go through this list together and decide how many of these are actually cool or are they spare. So of this 40 as the baseline, let's get some guesses out. Gary, how many do you think we will actually count as good movie weapons?
Now, these are movie weapons. This doesn't include like TV series and things like that.
Yeah, it's strictly movies.
I'm going to go with a high number. Out of 40, I'm going to say 33.
Bob, what do you think?
Yeah, I tend to agree. I think it is going to be a high number. I'll say 31.
Now, I have been privy to the list since I did the research, but I don't know how many you guys are going to pick. So I'm going to go ahead and throw out a guess also. I actually think your numbers are a little high. So I'm going to potentially take the under, and I'm going to go with 22.
Have you left out approximately 50 or 60 that are unbelievably fantastic? But I thought maybe you might just go with the lawnmower blade from Sling Blade or something like that.
No, but that is actually an awesome movie weapon. If you want to add that as an honorable mention, we probably can do that.
Some folks call it a Sling Blade. I call it a Guider Blade.
All right, so starting with the first one, we have the 44 Magnum from the Dirty Harry movie franchise. Is that a cool movie weapon? Gary is shaking his head yes.
That's a yes. Not only would I say that it was yes, but you can actually buy replicas of that thing. If they sell replicas, it's cool.
Not only that, it has a cool slogan to go with it. Go ahead, make my day.
Go ahead, make my day.
Yeah, is that the most iconic handgun in movie history?
I guess we'll see. We may see some other ones on this list that may trump it. I think it's very high up there, probably top five. All right, so we're going to say yes to the 44 Magnum. Next up, we have from the Conan the Barbarian movie, the Atlantean sword, which if you saw the movie, it's the one that he found in the cave that was kind of attached to that decomposing king or whatever. Pretty cool sword. And I remember when he was having the sword fights in that movie, his sword kept breaking other people's swords as he was swinging it. I think it's a pretty cool sword. What do you guys think?
I grew up watching the Conan movies with my dad. I love those movies and I would absolutely count that sword.
I'm in on S words.
Bob's always on board for a good sword fight.
You might just hook your sword and yank it out of your hand. Yeah.
All right, next up, speaking of handguns, from RoboCop, the Auto 9 handgun, which was kind of a mini machine gun. I remember that gun being pretty cool just because it had rapid fire and it would come out of his leg.
Yeah, I'd have to count that. RoboCop, that's a solid.
I would definitely count that. I think it's a cool looking gun.
I would completely agree.
So very long barrel.
What were some of the things he would say when he would shoot Junior? What were some of his good one-liners?
Your move, creep.
Next up, we have from the Wonder Woman movies, the Bracelets of Submission. What do you think of the bracelets that she hits together that makes the little explosion? Bob's on the fence. He's kind of mang this
golden
one.
Lasso's better than that.
Those, yeah, bracelets. You know what, I kind of agree. The golden lasso is probably more iconic than the bracelets, right?
Yeah,
I don't know about all that. So from a movie perspective, I don't know that they've really done a lot with the bracelets in the movies. From a TV show, they use it quite a bit. The bracelets are pretty powerful, man. And I got to say, Wonder Woman character in general is a lot stronger than people, I think, give that credit for. I would be on the fence about that. That's one of the ones that I might let go.
Now, if they were handcuffs, I'd be more on board, but not bracelets. So I'm going to say no. So this is going to be our first no on the list. How about, speaking of superhero weapons, the Captain America shield from the Avengers?
Vibranium.
Pretty iconic. Now, a shield as a weapon in general, kind of spare, right? Because you can only use it to block things. It's not really an offensive weapon.
Now, hold on a second. We've all seen the new Doctor Strange, right?
Yeah. Yeah, okay. Absolutely. Yeah.
All right. So I think we're all a yes then for.
Yeah, this is definitely not a split decision.
Next up, and this is, I think, maybe the first from a horror movie franchise, the Evil Dead chainsaw hand. What do you think of that one? The Bruce Campbell chainsaw ash.
Absolutely counts. But now, out of curiosity, is that the only ash weapon that's going to be on this list?
I believe so. So the shotgun arm, I don't see on the list.
This is my boomstick.
I would definitely count the chainsaw, but I would have counted both of them.
The shotgun was on here. I would count it too. So when we get to the honorable mentions, if you want to add that one in, we definitely can.
He better be glad that he didn't have that thing on him when he got the spell put on him. And Dr. Strange, he spent 3 weeks chopping himself up.
Yeah, I'm definitely in on the chainsaw hands.
Next up, from the Blade Runner movie, we have Deckard's PKD blaster. Kind of a generic gun, right?
Yeah, there's nothing really iconic about it to me.
I remember it made a cool sound. When it comes to futuristic guns, give me the light gun from Looker.
That's exactly where I was going next.
Over the Blade Runner gun.
We're going to need to add that in an honorable mention to respect the legacy of Noodles.
All right. So we're going to say no to the Blade Runner gun. Next up, this is a movie I haven't seen, but I have seen clips in it. They were really funny. Master of the flying guillotine weapon. Now, I have seen YouTube clips of this, and what it is, it's a guillotine in the shape of a bucket that people throw with a chain, and it lands on top of people's heads and decapitates them. It's one of those poorly dubbed kung fu movies, and the clips are shake laugh. I'm sure you guys probably haven't seen this before, but I'm going to count it just because it's so funny.
Yeah, it sounds really funny.
I'm looking at pictures of it right now. It does look funny. Go ahead and count it.
All right. I think we're going to give this one, even though it's sight unseen, we're going to give the flying guillotine a yes.
Yeah, it's a good enough concept.
Yeah.
I don't need to actually see it executed.
Now, this one I know Bob is going to love. Again, from another horror franchise, the flying metal spear.
Phantasm.
From Phantasm.
Number one. That is greatness.
It's kind of an oversell, but I will give this a yes, only because it burrows into your brain and
scorch out the blood.
It's a very, very cool weapon. And it's the only reason that the tall man is even semi-scary, because other than that, he's just a tall guy.
Comes in through the mirror at the end. Yeah. Boy.
Boy.
It's like Sean Bradley chasing you around for an entire movie.
Wheelchair?
Dang it.
Yeah.
Hi-ya-ha.
Ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ya-ya-ha-ha. So I would say yes to. Gary, would you be a yes on the flying spear?
Yeah, I'm a yes to that. And by the way, Sean Bradley in a wheelchair is still the tall man.
Yeah, good. Comparison to the rest of us, definitely. Now, from a horror movie franchise, I think this is the number one horror movie weapon. Nightmare on Elm Street, Freddy Krueger's glove.
Yes, very iconic.
That's very iconic. I think to me, that's number one from a horror movie standpoint. And Freddy Krueger in general is the number one horror movie villain of all time to me. Mainly because he actually had shtick and he wasn't just a generic killing guy like Jason or Michael Myers.
Can you count his tongue as a weapon as well?
Yes. I'm your boyfriend now, Nancy. little. But yeah, Freddy Krueger glove is definitely a yes, right?
Yeah.
No sure. Dissenters here. Next up, we have, and this is one of a couple of wizard weapons, I guess you could say, Gandalf's staff from the Lord of the Rings franchise.
Everything's
kind of generic. It's just a stick, right?
Yeah, kind of spare.
I mean, he makes it kind of cool when he says, "You shall not pass," and he hits the ground.
You shall not pass!
I'm not big on wizard weapons.
If it looks like it's probably mostly used to scratch your back, it's not a weapon.
All right, so you're a no, Gary?
Yeah, that's weak.
Bob?
I'd say no.
Now, this one, if you guys aren't familiar with it, I may use my exemption for it. Are you guys familiar with the movie Krull?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hold up.
Yeah, the glaive. Which is very similar to Freddy Krueger's glove. It's basically a star with a knives Chinese, at the end of it.
It's a Chinese throwing star, but bigger.
Yeah, and it boomerangs back to you. In the 80s.
It's got to be tricky as shit, though.
Yeah, boy, you really got to have good timing on that. In the 80s, Krull was one of my favorite movies as a kid, and that weapon I thought was so cool. This is a big yes for me.
Junior, did you like the movie better than the TV series?
Yes, I don't even think I saw the TV series.
Yeah, you did. Krull Show. We used to watch it all the time. Wasn't there a really solid Krull Vidya game back in the day, too?
Yes, there was, actually. And you would actually throw the glaive.
It sounds like it got named by Dr. Professor Frank.
The glaive. The glaive.
I love the colors, children.
All right, so we're going to give the glaive a yes. This next one, we may have needed Scott for this since he is our resident James Bond expert. How about the golden gun from The Man with the Golden Gun, which was the gun that was in pieces that Christopher Lee put together to shoot James Bond with?
And there's Spare? So many James Bond weapons and gadgets.
Yeah, that's a pretty healthy list, but I mean, they literally named the movie after this one. So I watched The Man with the Golden Gun not too long ago. The gun itself is kind of weak.
And it's one of the worst James Bond movies, too.
Yeah, I would say no to that, honestly. It's not, you know, it's a golden gun.
Yeah, and I would say outside of it being in pieces where you could kind of put it together inside of a little box, that's the only cool aspect to me. Like, you could carry it around and not consider it a weapon until you actually pieced it together. But other than that, pretty generic gun.
How many movies have we seen where they did that with a sniper rifle that's way more accurate and dangerous than that little pistol?
Yeah.
Yeah, I would agree. So let's say no to the golden gun. Here's another gun on the list from the Hellboy series, the Good Samaritan, which is the giant gun that Hellboy would carry Hellboy. Around.
You mean Mr. Fister?
Yes, Mr. Fister himself.
That's the revolver that just has the really big barrel on it, right?
Yeah, that goes to his giant arm.
Is this the Clay Morrow Hellboy or the sheriff from Stranger Things Hellboy?
I prefer the Clay Morrow Hellboy myself, but the gun is the same between both.
Oh, they used it in both? Franchise. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, because it's a comic book character, so that gun was part of the comic book series. I would be cool if you guys say no. I mean, outside of it being just a giant revolver, there's nothing else really appealing to it.
I don't think it's that big of a deal.
They
You can buy these things at Academy for like $500.
Okay, then we will say no to the Hellboy gun. This next one I am not familiar with. It's a movie called Existence. And it's the gristle gun. Are you guys familiar with Existence?
Shoots pieces of fat from a steak.
Yeah, that's the first thing I thought of is, man, it just shoots the pieces of steak that nobody wants to eat. Since I'm not familiar with it, I was going to give this one a no, but I didn't know if maybe you guys
it's a funny name.
About this one. It is a funny name.
Kind of looks like a jawbone, but no, that's a no.
All right, so we'll say no to the gristle gun. How about from Star Trek? If Jesse was here, I'm sure he would first ballot this one, the hand phaser.
Oh, how marvelous. Devastating. Why, this could kill millions.
It's iconic, but it's originated in the TV series. So I wouldn't even consider it a movie weapon.
Well, it was in the movies, too.
Yeah.
It was kind of cool that it shot that red laser.
Yeah, we discussed at least Wonder Woman, and that started off as a TV show.
I mean, phaser is pretty iconic.
Yeah, just the word alone, you just automatically think of sci-fi, and I'm sure that's.
And you can
the...
set it to stun. It doesn't necessarily have to
it's,
kill.
It's not, yeah, it's not necessarily a lethal weapon.
I wonder if they came up with the concept of the stun gun based on that. The idea come from that.
Stun guns were created in the mid 70s.
Ah. Yeah, and Star Trek goes all the way back to the 60s. So. Yeah, you could be onto something there.
Count it. I count it.
Yeah, I count it too. Next up, we have another wizard weapon, Harry Potter's wand.
Expelliarmus!
Again, it's just a piece of wood. It's a stick.
Why is everything in Harry Potter so foul?
Yeah, so basically, it's basically it's Mushmouth's favorite movie weapon.
I'm on the fence on this one.
I think the real weapon is usually the person that's wielding it, not so much
the stick. Yeah,
the spell itself. So you know what? I'm going to say no.
That's a no.
Yeah, I'll say no.
Now, this next one I think is pretty iconic. How about the Hattori Hanzo sword from The Greatness of Kill Bill, which is Quentin Tarantino's best movie?
You must have big rats. You need a Hattori Hanzo's steel.
Huge.
Got to count that one, right?
Absolutely.
I loved Kill Bill. I loved the sword. Lots of shake laugh whenever he's making it and he's working in the little sushi bar. Big yes for that one. Next one, I think Bob will definitely appreciate since he was a big fan of Tron. What about the discs, the identity discs in Tron?
I did like Tron, but...
The discs were spare?
Not spare, but...
Did you prefer the light bike?
Yeah, the light bikes were better.
Yeah, if we were saying movie vehicles, that would definitely make the
list.
I'm not going to count.
It
would box you in with the light bike, and then you ran into the light wall, and you would blow up. Yeah, Scott uses these discs to play disc golf.
Yeah. Wow, I'm surprised. I thought for sure Bob was going to say yes to the disc. What about you, Gary?
I'd be on the fence with that. I'd probably say no, but I wasn't a big Tron guy back in the day. So
when it comes to the Tron video games, there was two. There was the Tron Discs of Tron game, which I actually liked better than the Tron game with the tanks and the
you were
spiders.
Out on Tron?
No. I like both because I like the light bike portion of the other Tron game. But I thought the superior video game was the Discs of Tron, where you jump on the little discs as you throw the discs at the other person.
Did the Discs of Tron have the cool music like the regular Tron?
Yeah. All right, so we're going to say no to the Discs of Tron. This one, I think, is pretty iconic. Raiders of the Lost Ark. How about Indiana Jones's bullwhip?
Very cool scene, very cool movie. Excellent use of it.
So it's a cool whip?
Cool.
Yes, it is a cool whip.
You can't have a pie without cool whip. Cool whip? Cool whip, yeah. You mean cool whip? Yeah, cool whip. You're saying it weird. Why are you putting so much emphasis on the H? What are you talking about? I'm just saying it. Cool whip. You put cool whip on pie. Pie tastes better with cool whip.
But it's just a whip.
So you're going to say no to the Indiana Jones whip?
I mean, I really love the movie. I love the scene, how it's used. But ultimately, what's special about the weapon other than who's using it and how he's using it?
Tell me the title of our show again today. What is this?
Coolest movie weapons.
So is the whip cool?
You can't have a pie without cool whip.
I think the wielder of the weapon counts for something.
All right, I'll count it.
But yeah, I'm going to say yes because it's iconic. But I guess pushed into shove when he had diarrhea, he just pulled his gun out and shot that guy.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, whenever he didn't want to mess with having an actual whip versus sword fight, he just went to the old revolver. Next up, and again, this is going back to comic books and the Avengers movies. What about the Infinity Gauntlet?
Yeah, I would count that. The entire MCU hinged on that.
Well, when you snap a universe out of existence.
Yeah. Half of it, not the whole thing. Yeah, I think we have to count that. It has all of the little stones on it that do different things.
Plus, spoiler alert, it killed Iron Man.
And I am Iron Man.
So we're going to say yes to Thanos' Infinity Gauntlet. Getting back to the horror franchises, we mentioned this one a little bit earlier, Jason's machete. Not Danny Trejo's machete, but Jason's machete. Okay, now this kind of falls into the Indiana Jones thing.
Right.
It's just the machete, but I think the person wielding it adds to it. And it is iconic, kind of like the whip.
Jason killed people a lot of ways, and it wasn't just a machete.
But that's what he's probably most known for, right? Like when you think of Jason, well, you think of him.
He's most known for the mask.
The hockey mask, too.
Yeah. He's most known for killing you when you're just about to get laid.
Yeah, boy. Talk about the ultimate cock blocker.
On this one, I'm going to lean no. I just don't. It's not iconic. And plus, there were really only like three Friday the 13th movies before anybody stopped paying attention.
All right. So you guys are no?
Yeah, I'll say no.
Next up from the Highlander movie, Kurgan's collapsible sword.
Yeah, that's really cool. That's a really cool one. Because it's got very unique properties and qualities to it, you know?
It's a very generic statement. I have a feeling you don't even know.
It's collapsible!
It's in the title. Gary, are you familiar with Kurgan's collapsible sword?
Yeah, and I'm kind of a... I feel like I'm kind of a no on this one, too.
And does it squirt Jurgens, or does it just lubed up to collapse?
Kurgan.
Oh,
not okay. Jurgens. He wasn't using it to lube up and rub one out.
See, the problem was he heard sword and immediately he was just thinking how he was going to lube it up.
Yeah. And it's collapsible. So we're
all right. So we will say no to Kurgan's collapsible sword. Getting back to the comics, what about Judge Dredd's Lawgiver?
I never broke the law. I am the law.
Cool name.
I think that's the gun that when you give it commands, it does other gun functions, like other kinds of bullets it would shoot.
Yeah, it's a pretty cool weapon. It's not maybe not as iconic as the seashells.
He doesn't know how to use the three seashells.
I would say yes to that.
Yeah, I'll count that.
All right, so we'll give a yes to the lawgiver. How about from Planet Terror, the leg machine gun that the chick had when she was missing a leg and she attached the machine gun to her leg. Do you remember that from Planet Terror?
Oh, yeah, of course. She was riding in the back of the motor. It's, what's her name? It's
Rose McGowan.
Rose McGowan. I would say yes to this. It's kind of funny. I remember when she used it, she was either sitting on the motorcycle, facing backwards, shooting at everybody, or she was down on the ground with her leg hiked up like a dog pissing.
And I think it had like a some kind of grenade launcher or missile launcher.
Well, yeah, it would let her interchange the attachments.
Yeah, so it would like make her woo-hoo-hoo up in the air as she was shooting down.
Jerry, darling, it's all you.
I'd give it a yes just because it's a funny bit more than anything.
Yeah.
Next up, if I were to say what's the number one movie weapon of all time, what would you guys say it was?
Lightsaber.
Bob?
Yeah. Yeah, that sounds right.
Well, that is what is next. The Star Wars lightsaber.
What is it?
Your father's lightsaber. This is the weapon of a Jedi Knight. Not as clumsy or random as a blaster. An elegant weapon for the more civilized age.
So this is a first ballot, right?
Yeah.
Not much. So we'll give that one a yes. Next up, and I think this one is really cool, and it was one of the biggest and coolest things about the movie, the Aliens M41A pulse rifle that Ripley was using as she was mowing down all of the aliens.
I want to introduce you to a personal friend of mine. This is an M41A pulse rifle, 10 millimeter, with an over and under 30 millimeter pump action grenade launcher. Feel the weight.
What's this?
That's a grenade launcher. I don't think you want to mess with that.
You started this. Show me everything. I can handle myself.
I would give this one a big thumbs up.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Although, maybe even a better weapon was what she got in that giant exoskeleton crate mover and told the alien, get away from her, you bitch.
Get away from her, you bitch.
Next up, going back to comics and the Avengers, what about Mjolnir? And I guess they counted Mjolnir and Stormbreaker as a combo set. Thor's hammer / axe.
Whosoever holds this hammer, if it be worthy, shall possess the power of Thor.
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
Iconic, right?
Absolutely. Yeah, that's probably the coolest of all the Marvel weapons.
Really? You would say that is number one Marvel?
I think so.
Yeah.
Unless you consider the Iron Man suit itself a weapon, but yeah, I would tend to agree probably.
Yeah, now that I think about it, yeah, you might be right, Bob. I can't really think of a more the web shooters from Spider-Man, eh. Yeah, not as good as the hammer.
Wait, Spider-Man.
Try it.
They shoot out of his butt, or
does he look like a spider?
No, more like a man. Climbs walls, shoots webs. Yeah, bingo.
Out of his butt?
No.
Next up, we have from Scarface. Say hello to my little friend, Machine Gun.
Do you want
to
play rough? Okay. Uno. Say hello to my little friend.
Which also had a rocket launcher attached to it. But it was a very cool weapon, very cool scene at the end of Scarface.
I don't know if a single scene's enough to get a weapon into this thing.
Need more fake Scarface.
I thought it was a really cool machine gun, but there is other guns that do very similar things, including the Aliens gun that we talked about. And that one had more features to it than the Scarface gun.
You want
to
play rough?
Okay. We cockroaches.
The line's more iconic than the weapon.
Okay, so we'll say no to the Scarface machine gun. Now, this next one, we already said the lightsaber is number one. What would you guys consider the number two greatest movie weapon of all time? To me, this next one is number two. Just because it looks so cool. So
it was a hint.
To me, well, they use it to kill ghosts. How about that?
Oh, the ectoplasm. You know what's funny
is I almost mentioned that a few minutes ago. I was like, well, if you cross the streams.
There's something very important I forgot to tell you.
What?
Don't cross the streams.
Why?
It would be bad.
I'm fuzzy on the whole good-bad thing. What do you mean bad?
Try to imagine all life as you know it stopping instantaneously and every molecule in your body exploding at the speed of light.
Total protonic reversal.
Right, that's bad.
Yeah, so to me, the number two greatest movie weapon of all time is the proton packs that the Ghostbusters used to wrangle the ghost up, because it was just basically shooting lasers at people, and lasers are always cool, right?
Yeah.
So this is a big, big thumbs up for me. But like Gary said, can't cross the streams. It's only drawback.
I mean, you say you can't cross the streams, but that's exactly how they made the s'mores in the first one.
Yeah, that's how they got rid of there is no Dana, only Zool.
There is no Dana, only Zool.
What a lovely singing voice you must have.
And isn't that what they had to do with Hologram Spangler in the new one?
Yes. They had to cross the streams to get Hologram Spangler to come out and kill the new Gozer. All right, so we will say yes to the proton packs. Next up, another very cool one. How about the shoulder cannon from Predator with the three little red dots kind of just showing up as the target?
I wouldn't have thought of that, but yes.
That's a good one.
That's a pretty good one.
Plus, Predator also had those sword knives sticking out of his hand that would prop up. And when things went really wrong, he had that self-destruct with that weird looking language that he would use when there was no other options and he'd blow everything up. Next up, and this one, talk about low tech. No Country for Old Men, Friendo.
The bolt
now, gun. It makes it a combo. It says the silent shotgun and the air gun.
But the air gun's not an air gun. It's just a bolt. It's for killing cattle.
Sir, can you come a little bit closer, please?
Yeah.
What is that for?
Would you hold still, please, sir?
I would count that.
I actually was making a list. I'm sitting here making a little bit of a list of stuff that you haven't mentioned yet. because I didn't think that one was going to end up making the list, and I had it on mine, so that's a yes.
I would say yes to that one too, mainly for the shtick of the air gun more than anything. Next up, from Minority Report, are you guys familiar with the Sonic Shotgun? It's been a long time since I've seen Minority Report, so I don't even remember it.
Yeah, that thing is very cool. It looks like a sawed-off shotgun, like it's only a pistol grip. I'd say yes to that.
Bob, do you remember the Sonic shotgun?
I do not.
Is that what Sonic the Hedgehog was touting around as he was shooting Jim Carrey?
No, that's just what he used. That's how he drinks beers.
He shotguns him.
Sonic shotgun.
I may have seen Minority Report once, but I don't barely remember it. So
yeah, I'm in the same boat. You know what? I'm going to say no. All right, next up, Terminator 2, the T-800 shotgun. Now, this one, it's cool that he's using it, but it's just a shotgun, right? And it wasn't even all that effective against the Meltoid that he was fighting. I'm going to be a no on this one.
The cool thing about that was that it was a lever action pistol grip kind of gun. You got to be a man to shoot that. But no, that's, I mean, you know.
Yeah, I wouldn't count that.
All right, so we'll say no to the Terminator shotgun. From District 9, the arc gun.
Oh.
I guess you can arc it.
Gordo's favorite gun.
Arcing it. You blood shot! Hey, hey, hey!
Oh, holy shit! Ah! Ah!
Marizaniyama! Marizaniyama! I want to say that's the one that only the aliens could use. So whenever the guy got infected and turned into an alien, his arm turned into an alien arm. He was the only human that could use the gun. And I remember the gun being pretty cool.
Yes, the gun itself was very cool. I had forgotten about that until you said it, but that is a cool gun.
So I would say yes. Gary, you're a yes then?
That's a yes.
Yeah, so it doesn't matter what Bob thinks. We're going to say yes on this one. Next up, another one that is kind of unique from the El Mariachi movie and Once Upon a Time in Mexico, the guitar case gun.
He bolts out of the bar stool like you wouldn't believe. He grabs his case and he dives right in the middle of the room with it. Just dives right in. Now, I don't know what he does on that floor, but he's up in two shakes, his suitcase is wide open, and he's pulled God knows what out of it, but it's the biggest hand cannon I've ever seen.
Yes.
Very cool, right?
Very. Yeah. He called the guy that was from the original Air Mariachi, and he shows up. It's like an automatic weapon, but then he flips it up on his shoulder, and it's also...
It's a rocket launcher. Yes. Next up, I think this may be the first one from a comedy perspective. Monty Python and the Holy Grail, the Holy Hand Grenade of Antioch.
O Lord, bless this thy hand grenade, that with it thou mayst blow thine enemies to tiny bits in thy mercy. And the Lord did grin, and the people did feast upon the lambs and sloths and carp and anchovies and orangutans and breakfast cereals and fruit bats and large...
Skip a bit, brother.
It's too much of a bit, right? Like,
yeah, it's a bit.
I'm going to have to say no. Now, this is one that I think Gary mentioned earlier. Men in Black, the Noisy Cricket.
Series 4, deatomizer.
That's what I'm talking about.
Noisy Cricket.
Hey, Kate, no, come on, man. You get a Series 4 deatomizer, I get a little midget cricket. Oh, yeah.
Got to count that one. Although the one that the other guy, that Tommy Lee Jones was using, was the cool one, right?
It's a junior's phone when he doesn't turn off the ringer.
I would say yes to the Noisy Cricket just because it has a cool name and it's so tiny, yet it makes such a big boom. You guys in agreement?
There were a lot of guns that were very cool in that show, but that one was the one that they kind of named. So
yeah.
Next up, going back to the superhero franchises from the X-Men, how about Wolverine's adamantium claws?
Yeah. Kind of
very Freddy Krueger-ish, right?
They were Freddy Krueger-ish, but I mean, Wolverine existed before Freddy Krueger, so.
Yeah, so I would give this one a yes. Gary, you a yes on the claws? All right, so we'll say yes. Last one on my list, from the Fifth Element, Zorg ZF-1 pod weapon system. I remember Gary Oldman was the one selling that one, right? And it was the giant gun.
Voila, the ZF-1.
Slide. Handles adjustable for easy carrying. Good for riders and lefties. Strikes down on four parts, undetectable by X-ray. Ideal for quick, discreet interventions. A word on firepower. Titanium recharger. 3,000 round clip with bursts of 300 to 300. With the replay button, another Zorg invention, it's even easier. One shot.
And replay sends every following shot to the same location. And to finish the job, all is all goldies but goldies. Rocket launcher. Arrow launcher. With explosive and poisonous gas head. Very practical. Our famous net launcher. The always efficient flamethrower. My favorite. And for the grand finale, the all-new Ice Cube system.
You guys remember that one?
I only saw that movie once, too.
That one I've seen a couple of times, and I remember the gun because it was the one he was trying to sell to those aliens, but I wouldn't fight too hard for it. Gary, are you a no?
It's a no for me.
All right. Well, that is my list. So if you have some honorable mentions, I am ready to hear them.
The question that I would have is, what if there is a particular weapon that in and of itself is just a pistol that anybody could go buy if they want to go buy it, but it has been sort of a holy crap moment in several movies? The Desert Eagle.
I am not familiar.
They used it in Boondock Saints. They used it in Snatch. It was even the gun that they used in RoboCop. Like, if you remember in Snatch, when the guys came in, they were going to rob Bullet Tooth Tony. And he said, because your gun says replica on the side and mine says Desert Eagle .50.
And the fact that you've got replica written down the side of your gun. And the fact that I've got Desert Eagle .50 written on the side of mine. Should precipitate your balls into shrinking along with your presence.
You don't remember that scene?
Very, very loosely. When I think of Snatch, I think of Brad Pitt and his crazy accent.
Yeah, he was all Tyson Fury'd up.
Now, there was a problem with pikers or gypsies.
What are you doing, Potter? Get out of the way, mate.
You can't really understand much of what is being said.
You tell me. Come back to Cadra.
He's thrown ill.
Fuck, man. Tell me, Mickey.
It's not Irish. It's not English.
How are you?
Fair, the weather's been kindest for the horses, you know.
It's just, well, it's just piking.
Yeah. Oh, well, never mind that.
it's such give up.
I mean, it's a 50 caliber handgun, which is...
Hey, you know what, Gary? If you want to count it, I am cool with adding it to the list.
Okay.
The Desert Eagle Red Rocket Special or whatever. Yeah, which reminds me.
The Red Ryder BB gun.
The Red Ryder BB gun from A Christmas Story.
Oh, that would definitely count.
You'll shoot your eye out. You'll shoot your eye out.
Yeah, you got to count that.
I mean, you have the whole movie revolving around a gun, even if it is a BB gun. I think you do have to count that one. So I'm going to give that one a yes.
By the way, Deadpool used a 50 cal too, the Desert Eagle.
I'll give that one a yes. And you know what? We'll attach Deadpool to the Desert Eagle gun. Any other ones? What, didn't we mention one earlier that we said we were going to bring back up?
The Looker light gun.
Yes.
They use computer animation to put a hypnotic light pulse in the eyes of the commercial, but they're also producing a gun.
A gun? I don't like guns.
This is no ordinary gun. This gun gives the illusion of invisibility through repeated high-intensity light flashes.
I'm going to say yes, and if you guys say no, I would use my exemption.
No, I would use my exemption too, yeah.
We've talked about a lot of different kinds of weapons, but we haven't really talked much about the Rambo knife.
Oh, ooh. Yes, the serrated Rambo knife. I would count that one.
I would count that. I mean, they literally call it a Rambo knife.
Well, what we have here, huh? Why would you be carrying a knife like this?
Hunting.
Don't be a wise guy. What do you hunt with a knife?
Name it.
Yeah, anytime you have a weapon named after a movie, you kind of have to count it, right?
I mean, it was just a survival knife, but, you know,
nobody... had the compass and the thread.
Open so inside it, so the inside the handle, it carried more stuff. Because of the way he used it in the movies, the people call it a Rambo knife now, even though it existed before the movie. So I would say yes to that.
Yeah, he ended up having other cool weapons, too. He had that machine gun. And then he had the bow and arrow set with the arrows having bomb tips. That was kind of cool too. But yeah, when you think of Rambo, you think of the Rambo knife. So yeah,
it's the knife. And then he had the M60 is the big machine gun where he wrapped the belt of bullets around his arm.
And just shoots it in the air all crazy. Oh!
There's a couple of Marvel ones that we forgot. The first one, Gary is absolutely going to agree with me on the Yondu arrow that he whistle
controls. Oh, yes, yeah. Definitely.
Enough nonsense, Ravager. Time to suffer.
And I don't know if this is going to be considered a weapon or not, but it's very similar in its deployment to the shield that Captain America uses. What about Doctor Strange's cape? He gets it to do all kinds of crazy stuff. Like,
it is cool, but I don't consider that an offensive weapon. It's more of a defensive.
What about Aquaman's trident?
Ooh, there you go.
That one's, I would count that. Yeah, you know what? I would count the Aquaman trident too.
How about the Green Lantern's lantern?
Well, the ring. You know what? I would count that one because that one you can kind of use to make all kinds of cool stuff.
What about weapons. What about the Green Hornet's
Kato?
Kato? A living weapon? I think that one I would probably not count because he couldn't even beat Brad Pitt.
We get into a fight, I accidentally kill you, I go to jail.
Anybody accidentally kills anybody in a fight, they go to jail. It's called manslaughter. And I think all that lethal weapon horse shit is just an excuse so you dancers never have to get in a real fight.
Could you count the brain power from scanners?
No, it's not really a weapon. If it's part of your body, like your brain.
Yeah.
Adding up the yeses, we are at 33, which is the exact number that Gary gave us. So Gary wins both showcases by hitting the number on the head.
I promise you I was not counting. So.
Wow, you almost C-blocked yourself. You were trying to add one more.
Yeah, we had added bringing up the stupid Yondu arrow screwed me over.
All right. Well, great job, guys. If anybody would like to disagree with our yeses or agree with anything we talked about, give us any kind of feedback. You can reach us at How Many Podcasts on Twitter, or you can email us howmanypodcasts@gmail.com. You can reach Gary at travel_cowboy. You can reach Bob at lukewarmtallboy, or you could reach out to me at Metzkin_junior. You can also reach out to us on our YouTube channel where we have all of our backlogged episodes, or howmanypodcast.com. Thank you, gentlemen. We will talk to you soon.